snack. Me and you gonna have a little chat about books.
Hi guys, so I am here today to do a book review, and the book that I'm going to be reviewing is Dark Star. This is by Oliver Langmead. And I was sent this free by Unsung Stories, who are the publisher, so thank you very much for sending this to me. This one is a bit of a tough one to review, because I liked it, but I also had issues with it. So I ended up giving it a 3.5 out of 5 stars, which is a decent read. It's a very, very cool world, with lots of interesting ideas and original ideas that I haven't encountered before, and it's certainly a book that I've never come across another with a similar concept. But then I haven't read an awful lot of science fiction either, so that might just be me in my ignorance of science fiction. The city that we focus on for this story is called Vox, and it's a dark place with very, very few sources of light and no sun, which means that it's always dark. There are all sorts of criminals and nasty people who live around the outskirts of town, and there's drugs running rampant all over the place. Even the people in the police force have been affected by this, and people have very little hope. It's a very nasty way to live and a nasty way to imagine living. The thought and concept of a world without a sun is quite bleak, but a really interesting one to read about. The city of Vox is powered by three hearts, which give the city power. These are the main source of energy throughout the whole of Vox. One of them is stolen at the beginning of this book, leaving our main character, the investigator, to try and figure out exactly how it was stolen, who took it, why they took it, etc, etc. The plot reminded me a lot of the early Dresden Files books, which I've also been reading recently, in that it has sort of sci-fi elements to it, but it also is this real world crime noir investigation going on. So it's kind of a blend of the two. I don't know if there's a thing called urban sci-fi, but that's what I would call it. The main character is called Virgil, and he is well known in the town for a case that he solved quite a while back that was a big case. He's slowly gone downhill since his big break, and he's started going into the drug world and sort of getting hooked on these very dodgy things, and he's gradually fallen from grace and become addicted to Phos, which is a drug within this world. He's a good investigator, but he's clearly no longer on the top of his game, and he's not really respected by very many people in the world, because even though he tries to hide his drug addiction, it's quite obvious to a lot of people that he spends much of his time with. And as the story goes on, we see that he definitely has to face his reality and face that if he wants to solve this crime and if he really wants to figure out exactly what has happened, he's gonna have to make some lifestyle changes. The only niggle that I really did have with this book that really jarred with me was the fact that it's written in verse. I don't tend to read a lot of books that are written in verse, and I don't know whether it was the author or the publisher's decision to make it in verse. I assume it was the author's, but for me it really didn't work in verse, because the problem with verse is that every line has a capital at the beginning. And for me, when you're writing a story and you see capitals, it's the start of a sentence or it's the start of someone speaking. And that wasn't the case in this book because of the structuring. It meant that every line was capitalized, even if it was still an ongoing sentence or even if it was an ongoing piece of speech, it was still capitalized, which really broke up everything for me. It's not rhyming, it's not like rhyming verse where it would have made a bit more sense to me. It doesn't seem to have a real purpose. It does give it this kind of lilting flow and this poeticness, I suppose, in some scenes, but that wasn't continued throughout the whole of the book for me, and so it really just was more jarring than it was interesting to me. And that was my main complaint, was that I really didn't like the structure or the verse that they had employed within the story. I felt if it was just a written story in a normal format, it would have been much better and much less jarring for me, and I wouldn't have got distracted as often from the story. However, if you do read verse a lot of the time, maybe this is one that you would really enjoy, because as I say, I don't tend to read a lot of verse, so for me it was jarring, but if you do have a history of reading that sort of thing, it might be better for you. As the story went on, I did of course become more adjusted to the verse, and I found myself skimming over whether it was capitalized or not, and it wasn't as big of a problem towards the end where the story was starting to pick up. It was just a thing that distracted me for quite a while at the beginning and didn't really enjoy it. I felt as though the formatting was an attempt to make this book more interesting and stand out. And to me it did that, but not necessarily for the right reason. I think if it had not been formatted in that way, it could have been a 4-star read for me, but because it was, and it was so jarring to me and it was so disjointed, I could only give it a 3.5, which is still good. I still enjoyed the story. I still thought it was an interesting concept and the book was well written. I didn't have a problem with the pacing or the writing style. It was just the formatting that really did take me out of the story. So I'd love to hear if you guys have heard of this book. If you are interested in picking it up, then do let me know. The characters and the concept were decent and fun, and it was easy to get through and very quick to read. So I would love to hear your thoughts if you have read it or heard of it, or if you're interested in picking it up. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you all very soon in another video. Bye!
Me and you gonna have a little chat about the